Hello everyone, welcome to MBBS classes. Myself Dr. Hanifa. Today in this video I'll be talking on otomycosis, which is the fungal infection of the external ear. So before we begin, let me tell you about one strange fact about the fungal diseases of the external ear. The fungi, they are the common known commensals of the ear, but the primary fungal infection is less frequent. Let us see the pathogenesis of this fungal otitis externa. So, it is a known fact that the most fungus which are found in the ear are saprophytic, and the fungal infections which occur in the ear canal are generally opportunistic in nature, and the fungal otitis externa or otomycosis, it accounts for only 2% of the cases of the otitis externa. It is seen that the causative organisms or the fungi which causes otomycosis, they are mainly Candida species and the Aspergillus species. The Candida species, these are the yeast which causes the superficial infection of the ear canal, and it is especially a problem in people, those who are using hearing aids. And Aspergillus species, it is seen that they cause more aggressive infection because it involves both the epithelium and the subcutaneous layer. So here are the two otoscopic pictures showing the fungal infection of the external ear. This one is the clinical picture, a typical picture of otomycosis due to the Candida species. And here, and this is the otoscopic picture of otomycosis due to the Aspergillus species. Now, why in some of the patients they develop fungal otitis externa even though when it is a normal known commensal? Because in some patients with certain predisposing factors, it is seen. So, it is a problem mainly in patients with a chronically inflamed ears. And it is seen that though it is after treatment of the bacterial infections of the ear canal, the otomycosis is a more frequent problem. Because what happens after treatment of the bacterial infection of the ear canal with the help of topical ear drops which contain steroids and antibiotics, disturbs the milieu of the ear canal, and then it promotes the fungus which are present normally in the external auditory canal. Certain environmental factors also, they are conducive to the fungal growths. It is seen in warm and moist climate, the otomycosis is more in occurrence. Then it is seen sometimes in the patients who underwent open cavity mastoidectomy. When there is a big mastoid cavity, it is more prone to develop a bigger surface area, and when the cavity is a little bit moist, it promotes the growth of fungus. Then in a patients who are using the hearing aids, otomycosis is problem in them. And it is seen that those patients who are using hearing aid, the Candida is a more problematic pathogen for these group of patients. Now let us see the clinical symptomatology of the otomycosis. The most prominent symptom is the itching, and it is invariably present in almost all the cases. Unlike the pain in the ear, as we have seen in the classes of otitis externa, that the bacterial otitis externa, the main clinical presentation is pain. But in otomycosis, itching is the most prominent symptom. And pain in the ear in otomycosis, the ear becomes more painful when the deeper tissues are inflamed. Now, in some of the cases, they may complain of ear discharge, especially in cases of Candida infection. And in these cases, the discharge is smelly in nature. Now, what happens when these fungal colonies or the debris, it fills up the ear canal, then gradually the patient may develop oral fullness, and they develop the hearing problem. And the type of hearing loss is mostly conductive type of hearing loss, and it gets corrected as soon as the fungal colonies are cleared up by suction cleaning and by after proper debridement. It is said that always suspect otomycosis if a case of otitis externa is not responding to the conventional treatment and the patient continues to have itchy ears, then think of otomycosis. Then again, it is seen that the fungal infection, it develops more often in a setting of chronic suppurative otitis media. Because what happens in this case, that the discharge itself, it serves as a food for the fungi. And in cases of otomycosis with the CSOM, the pathogen most commonly involved is the Aspergillus. Now coming to the otoscopic findings of otomycosis case. These fungal colonies, they appear as a mass of whitish, it may be yellowish or grayish black color membrane which line the swollen erythematous ear canal. That means we'll get the ear canal will be slightly inflamed, it will be swollen. Secondly, we'll get a debris. The color of the debris may vary from one person to another. In some cases, you may get whitish color debris. In some cases, you may get yellowish, or in some cases, you may get grayish black color debris. And it is seen that otomycosis is invariably, it involves the deeper part of the ear canal. And now let us see how it looks macroscopically in cases of otomycosis due to candidiasis. So this is a clinical otoscopic picture of candidiasis. It appears as cheesy white debris in the ear canal. In cases of aspergillosis, they are characterized by the moist white plug or debris. They are dotted with these black debris and it appears like a wet newspaper look. These black dots, as you can see here, there are a few black dots which can be seen. These are the conduophores of the Aspergillus, and these two are the typical pictures of otomycosis due to candidiasis and due to aspergillosis. But you may not get the typical finding in some of the cases, and in some of the cases it may not be easily recognizable. So now to identify the type of pathogen, what has to be done is, after the debridement of these debris, these specimens must be sent for microbiological examination, microscopic examination and culture and sensitivity examination. So the salient features of otomycosis is, first is the location. It almost exclusively affects the bony portion of the ear canal. Then among the symptoms, unlike the other causes of otitis externa, itching is the main symptom. Then relation with the immunity. In most cases of otomycosis, the presence of otomycosis does not point towards any decline in the host resistance, unlike the fungal infections of the nose. Then if we see the course of the disease, it has a tendency to recur. Now the diagnosis of the type of the fungus, it can be made after debridement and by doing the microscopic examination and by the culture of the specimen. Usually the otomycosis, it does not lead to complications, but in some rare cases it may cause tympanic membrane perforation, especially if the fungal infection of the tympanic membrane epithelium is involved, then it may lead to perforation. Then if a person is immunocompromised, then these fungal pathogens, they may produce invasive disease with necrosis. Now coming to the treatment part. The first and most important treatment for the otomycosis, our main agenda is the thorough ear cleaning, because the thorough ear cleaning, it helps us to debride the fungal colonies, it helps us to clear up all the discharge, because these discharge, they act as a food for the fungus. Second is, after the proper thorough ear cleaning, it helps the topical antimycotics to reach the proper area, and to make the ear dry, it becomes possible only if the ear cleaning is done thoroughly. Next, our motto is to establish a dry external auditory canal by following certain habits. Like we ask the patient to eliminate the predisposing factors like use of hearing aids, like keeping the ear dry, do not let the water go inside the ear, avoid swimming. Then after the thorough ear cleaning, after debridement of the fungal colonies, they are advised topical antimycotic ear drops. In markets, it is available as a solution of clotrimazole, 1% solution. It is also available as 2% miconazole and ketoconazole drops. It is seen that in some of the patients who are not responding to the topical antimycotic ear drops, studies have shown use of the combination cream, especially combination of clotrimazole and betamethasone, if we fill up the ear canal, it helps in the quick resolution of the fungal otitis externa. Next is, Sometimes topical antiseptics also they help in the management of the fungal otitis externa, especially in cases of refractory cases. So in those cases, you may advise chrysylate otic drops and gentian violet also. But gentian violet is avoided in patients with the tympanic membrane perforation. Next is the acidification agent are used as the ear drops, because we know that the acidification, it helps to inhibit the growth of both bacteria and the fungus. And acidification agents, they may be like molecules like aluminium acetate otic drops, acetic acid or boric acids. Now the role of systemic antifungal drops, drugs, they are usually not needed. They are rarely required in the management of otomycosis. But if a patient is immunocompromised, presenting with invasive type of fungal ear disease, systemic antifungal drugs has to be added. With this, I come to an end of this video. Thank you for watching this video.